Good morning, guys. This is one of those diagnoses that you need to instantly recognize. I'm going to show you what the diagnosis is, but I want you to see what the symptom is. In here, it stands up, I go to start, and what happens? It dies. What caused that? The engine dies as soon as I pop the clutch. What's the diagnosis?
Well, if you've never seen this before, you'll be scratching your head, but once you've seen it, it's a very specific presentation. There's just about nothing else that'll do it. This is a classic story for a sidestand switch that's failed in the open position. Could be in the wires or the switch itself. Well, here's the OEM diagram from my bike. Here's the battery, the igniter, and the coils. The critical pathway to ground for the igniter comes along this wire, and it divides into three possible routes. The first is the neutral switch here. This one allows you to idle the bike in neutral on the kickstand and walk away. The second is the starter lockout switch here, which is inside the clutch handle. When you squeeze the clutch handle, this switch closes and you have a pathway to ground there. The third possible option for ground is the side stand switch. Now notice that if you put the bike into gear, you lose this one, and as you release the clutch handle, you lose that pathway to ground as well. That leaves only one pathway for the ignition to find a ground, so the engine stalls if the side stand is not raised. Well, why is that side stand switch there? You can imagine without a switch, it might be possible to absent-mindedly pull forward with the kickstand down while leaning to the right side. Then when you get some speed up and turn to the left, the stand could snag the ground and pull the rider and bike over. So the switch is there as a standard safety measure.
Here's the side stand. It's down, and so the switch should be open. And when you're riding with the bike, that switch right there should be closed. All right, I'll show you where we are here. That switch that's on the kickstand leads right up to here. So I'm going to undo that little connector right there to try and get at those ends. I could back probe it as well, but I'm just going to undo it and we'll see what the connections look like. Here's the connector disconnected. To undo that, you just press in on this tab and pull and it comes out. You can see two little male prongs in there. And so I'm going to take my connectors and get a connection there to see what's happening. There, that should be pretty good. Okay, I've got my multimeter set on ohms here, and I'm going to check the resistance of the circuit. Note that we're on the switch side of the circuit. And so the bike's on its kickstand now, and so we should have high resistance. And I'm going to tip the bike up, and I'm going to flick the kickstand up. Now, if this switch is working properly, we should have real low resistance here. And I can't see it at the moment, but I'm going to look at the viewfinder and see. But if I still have an OL sign, then clearly the switch is bad. So now that you know how this works, you can get a pretty good idea of how to fix it. The two wires that are in here, if you touch those two wires together, then the problem is solved. And if you're on the road, you could, if you had to, you could cut this and just tie the two wires together on this side of the cut, and there your problem is solved. Or, if you have the tools, you can take this off and lube it up, or even just tape it up properly. When I look at this here, I notice that the contact surface is a bit off, the angle is a bit off, and I think this might bear some lubrication. So what I'm going to do first is just undo it. This is a 4mm Allen screw, two of them. We'll just undo these and have a look at the mechanism. So as I look at this here, it feels really stiff, almost frozen. Take that little grommet off there. So I don't know if I can save this. We'll try and free it up a little bit. So now let's clean it off. First I'll start with WD-40 just to clean it. And that's just to get the grunge off of it. WD-40 is a great cleaner, but not a great lubricant, at least in terms of the long term. We'll get things moving a little bit and then add in some silicone spray here. All right, so watch this. I've got this lubricated pretty nicely. And if you watch the multimeter, I've got it set at ohms now. So when the kickstand is down, kickstand is down, this is what you've got. You've got high resistance. Kickstand is up, you've got low resistance. So it's now working normally. So we've got our problem solved, just with a little bit of lubrication. So now that I've cleaned things up with the WD-40, I'm going to follow that with some silicone spray because it works a little bit better. And I'll put a little bit of thicker lube inside the boot. But if you were wrote in and suggested I try this red and tacky grease, what the heck, let's give it a go. I've never used it before. Usually I use silicone paste, which works really well for most of these things. I just cleaned this part up here. This is the plate that the plunger presses on. I've cleaned it up. You can see it's tack welded into place, so there's no adjusting that. Let's put it back together and see if it works. Let's put a little dab of blue Loctite on these threads just so it doesn't come undone. Okay, now with the kickstand down, this thing has to be compressed. And so what I've done is I've wrapped some tape around it just to get it going. I'll get the thread started and get it into position. And I'll have to take the tape off somehow. The other option would be to support the bike in a different way. That's probably a better option, to support the bike differently. And then you don't have to monkey around with tape. But anyway, we've started along this path. We'll continue this way for now. Well, once you recognize the diagnosis, it really is easy, and the fix is straightforward as well. So if this video helped you out and you want to see more of them, then hit like or subscribe or leave a comment. I'd love to hear what others say, and of course, don't forget to click that little bell for subscriber updates. Thanks for watching.